Hi, my name is Savannah Dodd, and I'm the founder of the Photography Ethics Center. Welcome to our eighth video looking at photo ethics on film. In this video, we're going to look at an episode of the Gilmore Girls to talk about photographing events and public spaces. Let's watch the clip, and then we'll talk about it after.
Good.
I'm just thinking, this is really nice.
Me too.
Getting some good stuff.
Oh, yeah, the firelight.
The photographer in this clip seems really respectful, but there are still a few things that are worth talking about. First of all, it's worth talking about what's legal versus what's ethically all right. As we talked about in episode 2, there's a big difference between public space and private space. Legally, it's okay to take a photograph of someone if they're in a public space or if they're easily viewable from a public space. But just because somebody is walking around a public space doesn't necessarily mean it's okay for me to just take their picture. It's still important to think about asking for consent. As we talk about in the online training, consent could be passive, so it might just be somebody not saying anything or not saying no to you taking their photograph, or it could be more active, it could involve a conversation. There are some situations where you might be photographing a very large-scale event, and it might not be possible to get consent from everybody who appears in the picture. In situations like this, it might be a good idea to obtain consent from the event organizer. But it's important when we're thinking about consent to not only ask for consent to take the picture, but also to ask for consent to use the picture. It's actually when we're talking about the use of images that the ethics of this become actually a little bit more important. 75% of photographers who are taking our online training said that they would not feel good if they went online and found a photograph of themselves that they did not know had been taken. I think that this is a really interesting thing because this is coming from photographers themselves who are saying, wait a second, if I found a photograph of me online, I wouldn't feel very good about that. If most photographers wouldn't be comfortable stumbling across a photograph of themselves, then maybe we should think twice before posting photographs of others. There are many reasons why someone might not want to appear in a photograph. In particular, this could become a big issue in terms of safeguarding where children are concerned. If there are children present at a large-scale event, it's especially important to be very considerate of how we approach those situations. When children are present in our photographs, we really should do everything that we can to obtain consent from a parent or guardian. Maybe when you're going through your photographs later, you might see a child in the frame that you didn't realize was there at the time. In a situation like this, it's a really tough call, but sometimes it might be better just to not publish those photographs if there are children involved. I was recently doing a workshop with youth workers who were telling me about the importance of sensitivity about consent and safety when it comes to children, because sometimes children might be in the care system, and that maybe there is a relative who can't know their whereabouts. You just never know what the situation is and what kinds of safety risks that could pose for a child. If you have any comments or questions or personal experiences you'd like to share about photographing in public spaces, please share them with us in the comments section below. Thank you very much for joining me in this edition of Photo Ethics on Film, and I'll see you next time.